If you have administrative privileges on your ExactVision server, the Users page allows you to add, modify, or delete users. A new user has access to the server according to the permissions assigned to them by the administrator. To add a new user, click New towards the bottom of the page. Enter the name of the new user in the username field, followed by a password. Select a user role level from the user role drop-down field. There are 5 user roles by default in an ExactVision system. Full admin has access to all features of the system. A power user also has full access to system features, but cannot add or delete users. Live only will only permit users to view live video, while search only permits only the searching of recorded video. Live and searched users may view live video as well as search for recorded video from all connected cameras. The priority field is used to assign a PTZ and two-way audio priority level. Users with a higher priority level are granted control when 2 or more people are trying to gain access to that function. Users with a priority of 1 have the highest priority level. Admin users automatically have priority over any non-admin users, and power users have priority over all users except for admin users. If you wish to create a customized user role, select the New User Role option from the User Role dropdown. Begin by entering a name for the new user role. The user role created will allow you to use the same set of customized user privileges as a preset to use with new or additional users. From the Custom User Privileges panel, you may modify what this new type of user role can and cannot do on the ExactVision system. By expanding the Allow Live Viewing node, you may do such things as allow or remove the ability for a user with this role to view live cameras, to use PTZ controls, or to utilize two-way audio. Beneath the Allow Searching node, you may also allow or remove access to items or functions within the search, such as cases, metadata keywords, or the ability to export video. The Configuration node contains checkboxes for administrative functions. If the User Admin box is checked, the new user role will have the ability to create, edit, and delete certain users. If the View Admin box is checked, the new user role can administer saved views. Likewise, if User View Admin is checked, this role may administer user views. If the Case Admin box is checked, then the new user role will have the ability to create, edit, and delete cases on the system. PTZ Preset Admin allows the user role to administer PTZ presets on cameras, which is useful if you do not want users adding or removing presets previously configured. The Restricted View Admin box allows a user to create or remove restricted regions on cameras which are password protected. The final checkbox controls the ability for the user to be able to send a copy of their display using video push. An administrator creating a new role may wish to further narrow access to specific cameras or soft triggers rather than remove access to all cameras. Because an administrator has total access, in order to provide further granularity, you must first uncheck User Admin, View Admin, and Case Admin privileges. With these admin privileges disabled, you may provide or remove access to specific cameras, audio sources, soft triggers, or POS streams in live, search, or both. When finished, click Apply. The newly created user role will now be found in the User Role drop-down box to be applied to new or existing users. To change the password or permissions for an existing user, select a user from the User Accounts panel. Once selected, you may modify the user's details or delete the user using the Delete button. The built-in admin account may not be deleted. To create and modify users of multiple servers, you must have an Enterprise license and use the Enterprise Users page. Enterprise administration information can be found in a separate video. In addition to the User Details tab, an administrator may add additional user information on the Identification tab. This allows the administrator to record things such as the user's contact information or department within the organization. Lastly, the Security tab includes many functions to aid in protecting your system from undesired access. Here, an administrator may disable a user. This will leave their user account in the system, but will not allow that user to access the system. Full admin and power users always have permission to change their own password. Checking this box will allow users in other user roles to change their passwords as well, rather than being set by someone with sufficient privileges. The user must change password box forces a user to change their password at the time of their next login to the system. This is useful for setting up a new user in which the administrator sets an initial password but wants the user to pick something else for privacy. If selecting the temporary user checkbox, a user may be granted with short-term access or be assigned to an access schedule. Access schedules may be configured on the Configure System Settings page using the Security tab, or by clicking the Global Security Settings link here. Access schedules are useful for granting access only during a user's workdays or hours, preventing access outside those hours. Press Apply to save any changes. In a separate video, we will look at adding a user from Active Directory or LDAP.